afraid that we'll not have enough time. Anyhow, we will go on with Sergei Korenevsky from the Russian Academy of Sciences of Moscow with the paper Burials of the Military Elite of the Maikop Culture and the Symbolic Meaning of Gold and Precious Stones.
Dear colleagues, I know well that allocated time is no longer, so I try to show more show than speak. The Burial of the Military Elite of the Maikop Culture and the Symbolic Meaning of Gold and Precious Stones. There are a map of the Maikop Culture, main territory and periphery. There are modern radiocarbon chronology of the Maikop Culture based on more than 70 dates. Scheme has three periods: early, middle, and late. Early, middle, and late. Now we can correspond to of the Maikop Culture is dated from the time of Tepegavr 12 up to the early dynastic period, but the end of Maikop Culture is under question now. Some words about weapon. Weaponry is found often in the burial of the Maikop Culture. It includes various types of bronze daggers, axes, spearheads, and arrowhead of stone and bone. Weapon of shock action and stone blade weapon for close combat were rarely occurred. Burials with stone maces and axes of extreme rare. We have a little information concerning string or bone pickets. Bronze daggers of different type may locate in burial complexes. Warriors of the Maikop Culture were able to use complicated speed shot bow. The battle arrows were carried in the quiver. We may assume that the close combat of infantry was the prevailing kind of war action for the tribes of Maikop Culture, and that the bronze daggers became the most popular important of burial rites, both for war and for hunting. Statistic analysis help us to detect some artifacts group, a group with different content of gold in it. Every group includes a complex of weaponry, tools, and sometimes metalware. A group 1 consists 14 complexes with daggers, axe, flat chisel, narrow chisel, pick type chisel, and wear of metal. It is there are 14 such complexes. 11 complexes were escaped from a robbery. Gold was found in 10 graves, so it is consists of 90 of the burial places. There are pictures devoted to the Maikop Culture. New photos. A group 2 includes sets from daggers, axe, flat chisel, and narrow chisel without metalware. Such case is 14% of gold at the more low, about 50. Group 3 includes only daggers or axe and arrowheads. This group is more numerous and includes 40 cases. Percent of find of gold in this group is only 37. Complexes without a weapon consist of only chisel or hoe are very seldom and have not gold. Bureaus with fire of gold are semi-precious stones, but without weapon, possibly belong to women. One such case was identified with anthropological analysis of women of 25 or 30 from Kudahort Graves 1. Some groups' artifacts have high present of gold, more than 50. First of all, the group with metalware, 90%. New photos of utensils of Michael Kurgan. Skilly made daggers type of group Kishpek 1 has 82% of gold. Huge daggers, very skillfully made. A real sword of the Novosvobodnaya group was founded by colleague Rezepkin in richest grave 5, Kurgan 31, with big quantity of gold. It was implement of local production. But we can see the skin with the action of daggers from seal of Ur period. But the Novosvobodnaya sword had another mode of handle keeping than daggers of Aslan Tepe and daggers of Royal Cemetery of Ur. Simple leaf form daggers group 4 has 80% of gold in graves. Forks and hooks are 75% gold in bureaus. Last tools were probably used for management of cattle and intended for ceremonials of military ritual character on the base of seal of Babylon period. God is about Inanna Ishtar on the lyre, his folk, real folk from Sherry, and Michael's folks. Close to a big prestige of a weapon decorated by gold were arrow head of bone, 52%. Symbolical value of gold, semi-precious stones for people of the Maykop culture has been probably connected with magic of gold as metal of god of the sun. Semi-precious stone also had magic value. The carnelian has been most widespread. Torquoise, chalcedony rocks, crystal also were known. Seldom there is a lazurite. Its analysis show that it is connected with Badakhshan deposit in Afghanistan. Now we know about 14 graves with semi-precious stone. There are examples from Maykop culture and Staromoshastovsky hold. New pictures made by Canon Jesen. Different types of simple and complicated ornaments of the Maykop culture community. Examples. It is lazurite root on the base of date of Hermann and its Caucasus way. According to new finders, Baroque period. Thus we can see that weapon, gold, and semi-precious stone are reflected in the system of different ranks of ancient believers consist of some rulers, what and whom it is necessary to put in grave according to the prestige value of man or woman in society. Special questions. Now we know 15 anthropological definitions of the people of the Maykop culture. 9 of them were founded with weapon. All definitions were specified as a man. It would seem statistically strongly connects Bural with weapon and gold belong to bureaus of men. Whether is it exception of such case? I guess yes. It is complex of the Maikop Kurgan. All set of implements ornaments of this complex does not represent occasionally combination. It is unit by one idea deal with cults of tree of life and procession of animal, an animal under tree. Other idea was reflected by tools of for man and woman labor. Main diet person Bural Maikop Kurgan had a gold crown in the form of two types and 10 gold flowers. Gold crown are symbols of the tree of life. Flowers, leaves in the necropolis of Ur are connected only with female terms of priestess and princess. Therefore, we can assume that the in Maikop culture main grave was organized for a priestess and her servants. There were many attributes of front Asia of cult of new tree of life and godness in Anna-Ishtar. Probably its cult had androgen character, which godness in Anna possessed as patroness of fertility, life, war, and quarrel. Examples. Or gold band, skin on the Maikop bowl, beast on the tree with paw divided into two parts as hoof of the wild boar. Two bands and 10 gold flowers. Marx heard of both symbols of flowers. Here. There are examples from Ur by after Leonard Woolley. Crowns and flowers. As a whole, the examples of the Maikop culture reflect to the model of extremely warfare society with sharply expressed symbolics of military elite in burial rites, for which the prestige of feast and its attributes were very important in a combination with prestige of tools of work. But in itself, prestige of labor without of implement of war was nowhere in cult sphere. Most likely it was stage of proto-civilization, proto-chiefmanship, having close connections with Southern Caucasus and Kura lowland where culture Leyla Tepe has been extended. The most finest of weapons of bronze, gold, metal were dealt with, I guess, local production in Terek and Kuban region. It is possible to appreciate this cultural community as very developed center of warfare in the Uruk period, and metal production and gold production on the boundary of the Near East and East Europe. Many thanks for your attention.
Thank you very much.